I keep machine screws in this drawer in tin cans, but they don't make very good use of space, so I'm thinking I should make some rectangular boxes to fit in here. I want to use some thin hardwood that used to be some drawers in a cheap dresser, but I figure I can go much thinner than that, so I'm going to rip these in half, and I've already made a box to test this, and it worked out quite well. I just reset all these strips and I squared off the ends, and there's a few that I had to reject because I wasn't quite in the middle for some of them and they just came out too thin. So here's all my box sides cut, and I want to cut some finger joints in it like these ones. And that would be a crazy amount of work if I didn't have a screw advanced box joint jig. In terms of setting up the spacings on the jig, I figured out a long time ago that this particular blade with the 39 tooth gear against the 12 tooth gear and one turn per cut will make some very tight fitting finger joints. Now I just need to set the blade to be just a bit higher than the thickness of the material and put in my stock. I gotta make sure all the pieces are pushed against this fence here to keep them all aligned, and this part here is just a sacrificial piece to avoid tear out on the back. Got all the fingers on one end cut, now I just need to offset the jig by half a turn, rewind it, and do it again. Now, one thing that's really important is to keep the orientations of these consistent so that the fingers line up, which is why I marked all of the ones that were against the fence on one end like this. And now, with the way I've done the offset, I know that one end that's marked always has to meet up with another end that's not marked, and then they line up. When I made the previous set of boxes, I experimented with putting the glue on there just by dipping it in the glue. But that just puts the glue on the ends of the fingers, and I actually need the glue between the fingers. So I realized it's actually better to smear it across the fingers like so, and that gets it in there. Oh, this is backwards. There we go. So there's no need to clamp these because they're nice and tight, but I do have to make sure that they're square. For cutting the short little pieces, like these ones here, it gets very difficult because I can only come down so far with the clamp, and so I can't really clamp this very well. So instead, I'm going to use one of these clamps, but I have it configured as a spreader clamp, and I also cut a notch here so I can get that clamp further down to clamp those pieces in place. Well, I have to admit, this clamp worked so much better in theory than it did in practice. I just didn't have enough holding power, And so my pieces of wood kept slipping from the force of the blade. So I drilled a hole through here, put a threaded rod in with a nut that I can tighten against here. And that should give me plenty of holding power. The more boxes I put together, the faster I get at it. I've got a lot of boxes, and now I have to flush trim the protruding fingers on the joints. So I rigged this up on the table saw. There's a rabbet cut underneath this piece of wood, so that seen from the top, this edge is exactly level with the edge of the blade. And if I put a box against it right here, that'll trim the protrusions flush. Except I may have protrusions here. So to prevent the box from being crooked from those protrusions, I put another piece of wood on here. So I've got the corners all trimmed on these things, lots of boxes, and before I sand them, I'm going to make bottoms for them, and this is a good chance to use up lots of thin scraps of plywood. I'm trying to avoid using this part here because that's got defects in it. I deliberately oversized the bottom so I wouldn't have to be so careful positioning them, and now I need to trim those flush. I'm using the same flush trimming setup as before, but this time I tilted the blade by 30 degrees, and that puts a nice bevel on the bottoms. I'm running the pieces over the saw blade backwards to avoid tearing. Got 19 boxes all done, and I also put 2 coats of varnish on the outside to make them look nicer. The situation in my machine screws drawers is now much improved, and even though these boxes have very thin walls, they're quite sturdy enough to pick up by the corners.